Let us pray. O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So they shall invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
peoples in equity, the nations on you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth hear him. May God bless us in his mercy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the prophets, by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying God and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The words of the responsorial verse today: may the Lord bless us in his mercy. Truly echoes the sentiment we hold in our hearts as we come to this 8th day of the octave of Christmas. Of course, you know better than I do that Christmas, the solemnity of Christmas, is so crucial, so important that we don't simply celebrate it for a day. We have an entire octave when the Gloria is recited or sung at the Mass. Then the celebration continues until the feast of the baptism of the Lord through Epiphany to the baptism, which bridges the Christmas tide and the ordinary time. So that when we get to the baptism, we can now say farewell to the Christmas of this year and then begin the ordinary time. So if you have not taken down your Christmas decorations, you are not wrong. Let them still be. Look at them and let them remind you of the great love God has shown us and continues to show us by coming to become like you and I. So when we hear those beautiful lines from the letter to the Galatians, as the second reading of today reminded us about, that when the fullness of time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law. When we hear those beautiful lines, most people wonder what time is being talked about. If you are among those who do, ask no further, because the answer stares you on the face. The letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, second letter, tells us that now is the favorable time. Today. Today is the day of salvation. From the epistle to the Hebrews, we read that in times past, incidentally, that was the gospel acclamation of today, God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets. But in these last days, that is the favorable time, that is your time and my time, God is speaking to us through his son, through himself. He has got more closer than we ever imagined, getting as close as speaking to you as a friend can speak to another friend, as a family member would want to communicate with another family member, because that is how God has chosen to get down to us. 8 days ago, we celebrated his birth. He became like us, my dear friends, in all things but sin. According to Jewish custom, today should be his naming ceremony, and we had that in the gospel. They said, when 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. So according to this Jewish custom of circumcision, after that, the naming ceremony follows. And so it was today we can say that he was named Jesus. And the church invites us not just to recognize this, but to celebrate God's awesome gestures of love towards us and to honor our Blessed Virgin Mary, whom God had chosen according to his own plan at that appointed time to be the mother of the Redeemer. So the mother of Jesus, since Jesus was that word which was in the beginning with God and is God, through whom all things came to be. Since Mary is his mother, the church later proclaimed that Mary too is the mother of God. So we come to him today, my dear friends, in thanksgiving as we end this civil year. We have gone through a lot of challenges during this year. as well as in the past. You are all aware how many people have died from COVID-19. You know how many people have been hospitalized. You know the anxieties we still have, even mixing up as friends, holding back on some areas of our lives. You know the number of persons that have lost their career opportunities, a lot of windows closed, family members closed doors against each other, not out of will, but because they want to keep each other safe. Grandchildren, great-grandchildren come back to visit great-grandparents, grandparents, and they stand a distance to say, "Hi, Daddy, hi, Grandma," because we want to be responsible, because we want to keep each other safe and healthy. These are challenges. But coming to the end of this civil year, my dear friends, we are hopeful. We are hopeful that there is light. There will be light at the end of the tunnel. We are hopeful that a lot of things will change as we enter into this new year. So we present ourselves to let His love and blessings take us into this year that we are almost into. We pray that He may bless us in His mercy, re-echoing again the words of the psalmist, Psalm 67, verse 2. Already, His specifications are clear. In the first reading we had from the book of Numbers, about how He intends to bless us, and I am lifting the lines up as they are. The Lord said to Moses, "My dear brothers and sisters, I want you now to put yourself more composed and get yourself to pray with Moses as he carries out the injunction of God to us as we begin this year." He says, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them." Speak to Aaron. That's what God told Moses. "This is how you shall bless the people. Say to them, the Lord will bless you. He will keep you. The Lord will let His face shine upon you. The Lord will be gracious to you. The Lord will look upon you kindly and give you peace. The Lord will bless us." My dear friends, these words are clear. And God communicated them without mincing word. Not like He had water in His mouth. He didn't. So He communicated them as they are. So as we celebrate this Mass, we continue to pray that these blessings God had given to the people will also accompany us today as we come to the end of the year and as we begin a new year. So that through the intercession of our Blessed Mother Mary, the Mother of God, God's plans for you this very year will come to its fulfillment for your happiness, the happiness of your homes and families, of friends, of your goals, so that we will continue to enjoy His favor. If this is the favorable time, then let that favor be upon you, upon your household, upon your concerns, and upon everybody who is there to you. Judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Our loving Savior has given us the Blessed Virgin Mary to be our mother. With confidence in the Father's care, we now pray.
That Mary, Mother of the Church, will guide and protect the Church with her motherly love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this World Day of Peace, that Mary, Queen of Peace, will intercede to bring lasting peace to the world. Let us pray.
to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For families who suffer from financial hardship, for all our families that are separated from others during COVID, that this new year will be a time of peace and abiding love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the intercession of Mary will draw our parish community closer to Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the homebound, the sick, and for the souls of our deceased relatives and friends, and for those who have gone before us with the sign of faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of the parish of whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those intentions written in our Book of Petitions, and for those intentions we carry in the quiet of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, hear the prayers of your people gathered to honor the most holy mother of your Son, our Savior, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
Please join us in singing the song for the gifts, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman. Your womb, Jesus.
My dear brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. And all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body and one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, Robert, John, and Ramon, our bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own, listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, Lord, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord.
Be
be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And may we share the sign of peace. The Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are invited to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to life everlasting. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord, grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. And in case we don't see you tomorrow, Happy New Year.
Thank you, Father.
God bless you.
God bless
you. Eucharistic ministers, please.
Thank you. Let us all sing together, O Holy Mary.